Let's start with the Docker installation. To access the command line interface on your computer, open the terminal application. In the video description, you can find a link to the documentation with the necessary commands you need to run to install Docker. Create the Docker group using the command sudo group add docker. This allows users in the group to execute Docker commands without the need to use sudo every time. Add your current user to the Docker group by running the command sudo usermod add docker, followed by your username. If you still don't have access to running Docker without sudo, you should restart your computer. Reboot the system. If you do not have Git installed on your laptop, you need to install it. So let's install Git. And done. Now let's install CVAT. Open the terminal and run the command git clone, followed by the repository link to download the CVAT code to your system. Go to the CVAT directory. It is recommended to use Google Chrome as the browser to run CVAT. Therefore, we need to download and install it. Now, run the command docker compose upd to start the CVAT Docker container. This process may take some time, so be patient and wait until it's finished. To ensure that the local version of CVAT works correctly, it's crucial to wait until the server is up and running. When you run the CVAT server for the first time, you have to create a superuser account. Enter your desired login and password to create the account. That's it. CVAT is now available on your local machine at localhost 8080. Annotate faster and with higher quality using CVAT. CVAT is an open-source platform for preparing datasets at scale. You can find more information at cvat.ai.